Dr. Silvera, good to see you again. And let's start first with this new study that Pfizer released about how effective its vaccine is on children. Do you think that this study will be key for the FDA as it makes its decision?
Absolutely. And I think there are two really important findings that they released today. One is that there were no cases of myocarditis, which has been a concern, especially for these vaccines in younger individuals, but also that it's not above 90% effective against symptomatic illness. So that 90% range that we saw for adults was about severe illness, hospitalizations, and deaths. This is looking at symptomatic illness, meaning it's even more effective in this population.
Are you expecting FDA approval on this then?
I would be surprised if they did not approve, yeah.
So the timeline for that, it's going to happen pretty quickly. The FDA is meeting very soon, and that's after, of course, all the meetings this week on boosters.
Right. So I suspect they'll have their meeting. They will likely approve it. And then early the following week, we'll start being able to roll out those shots for children. And I think the goal is to get it before Halloween, but I think it'll probably come shortly thereafter.
So give me your thoughts about what unfolded this week with the recommended approval for boosters, and then the CDC signed off on that late last night. Do you think there will be a huge influx of people who seek boosters?
So I think we're probably likely to see more people who got the J&J vaccine go for that second dose, because I think there's been a lot of concern in that particular community about how effective those vaccines have been. And they're now eligible not only to get a second dose of J&J, but they can pick any vaccine. They can get Pfizer or Moderna. And I think that's probably going to cause some people to be a little bit more comfortable. I also think that as we go into this next holiday season, we're going to see an increase in the number of people who want to get that booster because they want to be able to get together with their family and feel safe to do so.
What's the likelihood you think move forward that we might see the recommended age lowered below 65 for healthy individuals?
So I think we're probably going to head in that direction, though I think it's really important to note that the vaccines, even without the boosters, are still working for the most part. They are still highly effective vaccines. I think what we're going to get into, especially as we move forward and we see what new variants emerge, that there's going to be a desire for some populations to keep themselves extra safe, especially if they have members of their family who are at higher risk.
And in terms of new variants, we know already there's a mutation of the Delta variant in the UK that people are keeping close watch on. Are these boosters going to fully protect us as the virus continues to mutate?
So unfortunately, until those mutations appear here, we can look at international data to see how well their vaccines and their booster programs are working. But we can't really know until the variants are circulating. That said, if we keep transmission rates of COVID of any variant low, then the virus has fewer opportunities to mutate. So our best way to combat or protect ourselves against future mutations is to get vaccinated now.
Dr. Silvera, good to see you again. Thank you.
Always good to see you. Thank you for having me.